Okay, welcome guys. This video I'm gonna talk about the difference between gerunds and infinitives after these verbs. Our first verb is stop, forget, remember, and regret. Okay, this is a testing for my life, so I'll see how it will work later. Testing. Okay, hope you like it. Then we hope to help you. Good. The connection is excellent. Let's see here. Okay, so when you use stop, check on my audio. Hello. Let me hope you can hear me. Okay, great. Now, okay, great. So here we've recorded. Okay, so how do we use stop before a gerund? As you know, gerunds, it's a verb. The gerund, we have the verb plus ing. That is a gerund. Remember, a gerund is an action. Okay, a gerund is an action. It's a noun form. Okay? Right. So I'm going to give you examples of gerunds. For example, swimming is a gerund. Reading is a gerund. Writing is a gerund. So things like hobbies, things like habits, all those are gerunds. So all these words or gerunds can come after these verbs. We have five verbs. Okay, but the first one you're looking at is stop. So when you see these verbs followed after a gerund, what do we mean? Okay, this is the technique, or this is the logic behind this. Whenever you see these verbs and they're after these verbs, for example, stop. Let me give you an example. He stopped to smoke. Okay, for example, we have this sentence. He stopped to smoke. But this is, sorry. He stopped smoking. Okay, this is the gerund. Our gerund is smoking. He stopped smoking. So what's the meaning of this sentence? What is the meaning of this sentence? English learners, you must know the meaning of this sentence. Okay, whenever you see such a sentence with this verb on our list, it means that this action was permanent, or it is a permanent action. This guy no longer smokes. He finished smoking. He quit. Okay, quit, that's a good word. He quit smoking. So here in this, our first verb, our first action, was smoking. Okay, first action was smoking. Okay, don't forget this. This is the technique I'm giving you. The first action he was doing. Okay? The first action in this sentence is smoking. Okay, smoking was the first action. This guy was doing smoking, and then he stopped. Then the second action. The second action was stop. Okay, see that? The second action was stop. So this guy stopped smoking. Okay. together. Of you together. Are you there? Are you there? Okay, good. So you see that.
So as you can see in this sentence, each of the small things permanent action, permanent. He no longer smokes. He quit smoking. So here the first action was smoking, which is the gerund. As you can see with all this, the first action is the gerund. Okay? That's the strategy. The first action is the gerund. Then the second action is the verb. It's our second action. The verb is our second action. Yeah, our first action was smoking. So, that is the beauty of gerunds. So, all those verbs, all those gerunds that come after stop, it means they are the first actions that take place. Then, stop happens. For example, he stopped smoking. He stopped reading. This is a parent. So, always with gerunds, their habits, their real. They are facts. They are also habits. Habits and hobbies. Most of our gerunds are this. Okay? They are real facts and hobbies. So let me hope the first one you understood it. Excuse me. So this was the gerund. Followed. Now let's see the infinitive. What's the meaning of the infinitive when the infinitive is following stop? Okay, so let's see how clean our board. So let's say he stopped. Smoke. Okay. What's the meaning of this? He stopped smoke. Now, the meaning of this is temporary. It's temporary. Temporary. So this guy stopped, or this person stopped to smoke temporarily. Okay, to do something else. Okay. So the first thing he did here, this sentence, the first action was stop. Okay, this is the first action. He stopped. First action is stop. Stop was the first action. Okay. And then the second action is smoke. Okay. See that? The second action is smoke. Or smoke. This guy wanted to do something, then he stopped to smoke. He was doing something, then he stopped to have a cigarette. He stopped to smoke. So is the meaning here? The meaning is different from that of the gerund. With the gerund, permanent. He stopped completely. He quit cigarette. He quit smoke. However, with this sentence, he stopped to smoke. It's temporary. Okay? He stopped to smoke. Maybe somebody knocked on his door. For example, his mom knocked on the door and he stopped. So as to open the door. This is example, very good one. His mom knocked on the door and he stopped. So as to open the door. So this guy was smoking. Okay, and then he stopped to smoke so that he could open the door. As you can see, the meaning is different from the first example with the gerund. It's another meaning of infinitive when it is followed by before stop. Let's say, look at an example. He stopped to talk to me. That's very good. He stopped to talk to me. So, what does it mean? He stopped to talk to me. This guy was working. Maybe he was working or he was doing some work. And then when I came in, he stopped so that he could talk to me. So the first action, okay? The first action is stopped. Okay? He was doing something. You see, then he stopped. This is our verb. Then he stopped. Then the second action, to talk. Okay. He stopped so that he can talk to me. So here, the infinitive is the second action. Okay? The infinitive is the second action. Write it here. The infinitive is the second action. That is the strategy. Okay? With the gerund, the gerund is the first action after this verb. But with infinitives, always after this verb, the infinitive is the second action. Forget that. Let me repeat that. With all these verbs, when they are followed by an infinitive, the infinitive is always the second action after the verb action has taken place. You got that? That's the difference. Whereas with the gerund is always the first action before the verb action happens. So let me hope you got that technique. That's the strategy for all these verbs, for all these five verbs. Remember, forget, regret. So here, it means that he was doing something, he was doing something, and he stopped. And he stopped. Sorry. And he stopped to talk. He stopped to talk. It doesn't mean that this guy no longer talks to me, we no longer see each other's faces. No. It's just that it means that he was doing something and then he stopped doing whatever he was doing and then he talked to me. Sorry, I have to move this. That's the meaning of this sentence. Okay, so stop, finish. Let me hope you got. If you have any questions, please ask me in the comments and I will assist you whatever you learn. Okay. Are you there? Okay, good. So this is what we have. This is what we have. So let me hope you are enjoying and you're learning something. Okay. So let's continue. Now, stop, finish. Let's go forget. Let's do forget. For example, I forgot to close my house. Let's just do gerunds. I forgot to close. What's the meaning of this sentence? I forgot to close my house. I forgot to close my house. Okay? From our strategy, the gerund is the first action, okay? Gerund is the first action, then our forgot is the second action. So here it means he closed his house, but doesn't remember. Okay, that's the meaning of the sentence. It means that I closed my house, but I don't remember. I closed my house, but I don't remember. That's the meaning of this sentence. The first action is closing. I closed my house, but I don't remember. Okay, first action. Let me do it here. Action one is closing. He's a gerund. Okay. Action two is, okay, past tense, then you like that, forgot. Passion to is forgot. So the first thing is, I did close the house, but I don't remember, I forgot, you know, I don't remember that. Okay? So let's see the infinitive, let's see the infinitive meaning. I forgot to close my house. Okay, I forgot to close our infinitive is here, which is blue, and I forgot is our verb. Okay, our verb in black. So what's the meaning of this? I forgot to close my house. What's the meaning of this? Okay. I forgot to close my house. So this means, I forgot to close my house means I totally forgot. Okay? I totally forgot to close my house. And fear that thieves will go in. You see? Here, action one. Sorry. Here, action one. Action one is the verb. Okay? Action one is forgot. And then action two is close. You see? That's the beauty of the strategy. If you have the strategy, then it will be very easy for you to understand the meaning. It will help you to comprehend and understand the meaning of this when you listen to native speakers using these expressions. Okay. I forgot to close my mouth. I totally forgot. So the first action is in the mind. I forgot to do the action. So this is the meaning between these two examples. So let me hope you understood. If you understand, please drop me in the comments and tell me what you think. I'm waiting for you to tell me what you need. And so drop me. To close my house, I totally forgot to close. Let's look at it and then read and see. Let's see, remember. So what do we do with remember? I'll clean this. So I remember seeing you yesterday. Okay. I will remember, and I went around here. So what's the meaning of this? Somebody says, I remember seeing you yesterday. So our first action is see. Our second action is remember. Okay, what does it mean? It means that this guy first saw him. He saw him yesterday. And he remembers that. This is the second action. Okay. I remember seeing you yesterday. It means they met yesterday. Which means they met. They met yesterday. As simple as that. They met yesterday and he's seeing him again today. You see, they met yesterday and they are meeting the second time. That's the meaning of this.